Hi, my friends. Now I will show you our work, my and my team. Then we study about a calculation of the cross-sectional area of a power transmission belt between two pulleys to avoid the resonance phenomenon. This is our work, and this is our title for present in First South Florida Congress of Development, Miami. Good. My team is Leonardo, Guilherme, Kelvin, Natalia, Isley, Vinicius, Anderson, it's me, and Wellington. All of us are Brazilian, and our work in introduction, we present our subject, and we say that mechanical transmission elements are sets that enable the transmission of power. Torque and rotation between the elements of a machine thus begin responsible for maintaining the proper functioning and performance throughout the operation. The system of pulleys and belts, which are the elements used to maintain the rotation synchronism of different parts, has the most varied applications in engineering such as automotive, aerospace, energy, automation, among others. The importance of correctly designing a system or machine that is exposed to vibrations due to cyclical movements generated by external force or by its own movement becomes evident. Depending on their design and operations characteristics, they can result in the resonance phenomenon causing the failure and fatigue of its components. Our problem. Our problem is the belt drive is widely used in the fields of engineering and industry, mainly in machinery. Due to the widespread use of the belt drive system, situations in which machines and equipment are exposed to excessive vibrations are common. Due to the lack of proper maintenance, wear of the components, or due to the pack lack of dimensioning. The system studying this work is adaptation of a problem of vibrations of mechanical components, like our five reference. The figure 6 represents the assembly configuration that will be covered in this work. The system consists of two pulleys and a belt responsible for transferring power and torque. Torsional system. When a rigid body oscillates in relation to a specific reference axis, the resulting movement will be called torsional vibration, and therefore the displacement is measured in terms of angular coordinate. In this case, the restorative movement is due to a twist of an elastic element or an unbalanced moment of a force or conjugate, like we can see in 5. Torsional vibrations are very common in rotating machines, such as the pulley and belt mechanism of the system analyzed in this work. Good. Still about torsional system, every object has a natural frequency of oscillation. The natural frequency of an object is characterized as the frequency that a body weight undergoes an initial disturbance, oscillates without the action of external force. For a system with 10 degrees of freedom, there will be n distinct natural frequencies, like 5. During the operation of machinery and equipment, the phenomenon can induce excessive wear and premature failure. Even small or normal force, such as imbalance of misalignment of pulleys, can cause extremely high amplitudes of vibration, like we can see in third reference. Most famous examples of the phenomenon and which have video records are the Tacoma Bridge, built in the United States, and which collapsed shortly after its construction due to the wind frequencies in the bridge region coinciding with one of its natural oscillation frequencies. There are two ways to identify the natural frequency of an equipment of or structures. The mathematical method, which consists of analytical calculations or computational mathematical models, and the experimental method. In mathematical methods, it's possible to predict the natural frequency or the structure without the need for its construction, either by analytical methods or numerical methods. In the experimental method, the natural frequencies are obtained induced by oscillation by external force and analyzing the displacement. We can see more about this in 7th reference. Our methodology. The belt is a flexible connecting element usually made of layers of tarpaulins and Vulcan's and rubber, like we can see in 4 reference. In the model, the belt is treated as springs that interconnect pulleys 1 and 2. For the torsional system, the pulleys have moment of inertia in ready I1, I2, R1, and R2, respectively. Figure 3 shows the simplified model of the assembly. Thus, the general solution and the first order derivative of angle theta 2, they can be rewritten according to equations 15. Results. Our results show that it is possible to observe that the values of the analytical solution and the numerical solution are coincident as expected. Therefore, it can be concluded that the analytical solution is adequate. Our conclusion is that a mechanical system composed with a power transmission belt between two pulleys of different size was mathematically modeled from a system of two second order differential equations. The general solutions obtained were the angular positions of the two pulleys as a function of time, and the functions found were in the form of cosine of the oscillation frequency times time, a data. To verify that the analytical solutions was coherent, an initial value problem was created with arbitrary initial conditions to make it possible to compare analytical solutions with numerical solutions. When comparing the analytical and the theoretical values of the angular positions as a function of time for the two belt cross sections, areas obtained, it was possible to conclude that analytical solution is adequate. Good. Here we don't show our equations and process because the time is short, but our work have a demonstrate. You can see after in page of Congress, and this is our bibliographic reference. Thank you a lot. See you.